So by now you know that I am a huge advocate for Lightroom's cloud-based ecosystem on desktop and mobile devices. In addition to sharing helpful videos about it here on YouTube, I also created an entire course about it called Lightroom Everywhere, which I'll link to in the description below. Now, I totally understand that there are still a lot of Lightroom Classic users who are kind of interested in seeing what Lightroom has to offer, and I really think that's an awesome mindset to have, which is why I'm sharing this video. Sometimes the best way to get comfortable with a new app is to take things slow with baby steps, especially when it comes to the photo editing tools that you use. And the great news is that both Lightroom and Lightroom Classic share the same editing tools, even if they're arranged a little bit differently. You can edit a photo in Lightroom Classic, and those edits will appear in Lightroom, and vice versa. And that should be a very comforting thought, because it means that A, you can carry over edits made in Lightroom Classic into Lightroom, and B, any edits you make in Lightroom as you explore the app will be available to you when you go back in Lightroom Classic. Trust me, this is a really approachable way to get comfortable with Lightroom, so let's dive in. All right, so the name of the game for this video is to show you that you can take edits made either in Lightroom or in Lightroom Classic and kind of sync them between each other. This is really important because, like I just said, for those of you who are interested in getting to know this version of Lightroom, which I do believe is the future of Lightroom for Adobe, it's important to familiarize yourself with the editing tools. And one of the ways that I think that'll kind of put people's minds at ease is knowing that any changes that you make or edits that you make to your photo in Lightroom will be accessible here, and again, vice versa. If you make an edit in Lightroom Classic, you should be able to see it here. Now, the important point that I want to make is I am in Lightroom's local browse. I have a video on that, which explains what local browse is and why it's one of the most important updates to Lightroom since the app was released. Now, you might notice that both in Lightroom and in Lightroom Classic, I have the exact same six images. Basically, I have two JPEGs, two DNG files, and two RAW files. Same thing here. And the star ratings are basically used to sort the images. So I'm just sorting by numerical stars. And the reason why I have two of each file type, or two of the most common file types, I should say, is because for one of them, I'm going to show you how, if you make an edit in Lightroom, how to get that edit into Lightroom Classic. And then the second one, if you make an edit in Lightroom Classic, how to get it to reflect in Lightroom here on the desktop. Now, all six of these images are unedited. No changes have been made to them. So they're basically the equivalent of straight out of camera. Also, on the desktop here, I have a folder, and you can see the two JPEGs, the two DNGs, and the two RAW files over here. So just to show you that it's pretty much as vanilla as you can get. All right, let's get started. All right, so the first thing I want to do is edit a JPEG in Lightroom and show you how to get it into Lightroom Classic over here. So the first thing we'll do is double click on the image here. You can see we are in the edit panel in Lightroom. I'm not going to do anything special here. I'm just going to click on auto. I'll go ahead maybe and make the exposure a little bit brighter, and I'm gonna add one of my favorite S-curves for some contrast. Now, you can see this image has been edited, and if I go into Lightroom, you will see nothing. You can wait here till the end of time, and this image will never change. And the reason for that is, if you make an edit in Lightroom's local browse here, in order to commit that edit, in order to tell Lightroom to say, okay, I'm done with this edit, write that information to the header of the JPEG, you have to do one of two things. You either have to press G on the grid to go to the grid view, or you can press the left or right arrow keys to arrow over to the next image. If you do either of those things, you're telling Lightroom, all right, I'm done with my edit session, write that information in. So I'm gonna go ahead and press G on my keyboard, and that tells Lightroom, okay, now it's time to write the edits I made to the header information of this JPEG. Now, when I go to Lightroom Classic over here, here's the image. You might not see anything change until you click on the image. Still, even if you click on the image, you might not see anything change. In this case here, you should have noticed right here, this little icon appear. This indicates that there is a metadata change to this image. If for some reason you don't see that still, what you can do is right-click on the folder that contains that image, and then go to synchronize folder. And then when you synchronize that, Lightroom should definitely see a change in the metadata. So what Lightroom Classic is telling you is that, hey, I have this JPEG here and I have the information about it in my catalog, but the actual file, this file right here, this has different information in its metadata in the header. So what do you want to do? Well, if you click on this icon here, you have two options. You can either say, all right, I'm going to take the information you have, Lightroom Classic, in your catalog, and I'm going to overwrite it. That is not the option you want. You want the second option, which says import settings from disk. And that's telling Lightroom Classic to take the information in the JPEG metadata and overwrite its own records. So when you click on this, you'll see, boom, there are the edits. If you go into the develop module here, you'll see there are all the edits made, including the S curve that I applied in the tone curve here. And so again, now I've kind of illustrated that edits you make in the Lightroom, let's say you're new to Lightroom and you're exploring the editing tools, you can now see that the edits you've made to JPEG can be transferred over in kind to Lightroom Classic. And again, that should be a very comforting thought. Now let me show you the reverse way. So let's go to the grid view and open up this JPEG here. I'll go to the develop module. And again, I'm just gonna go ahead up here and click on auto. I'm just gonna get a white balance and just kind of, you know, make some changes to the image here. Let's add some contrast using the contrast slider. Basically, I wanna make it very clear that this image has been edited. So now what I'm gonna do is go to the grid view. Just like before when I said we can go here in Lightroom and wait till the end of time and nothing will happen. And the reason for that is because the information, the edits we made, they have not yet been written to the JPEG. And there are one of two ways you can do that. In Lightroom Classic, you can either export this JPEG as a new file, and obviously those changes will be written to it. But we don't want to do that. We want to just work with the original image. We don't want a bunch of duplicate photos. So the way that you write the information to the photo is by going in the library module, make sure you're in library, with the image selected, you'll go to your menu here, you'll then go to metadata, and you're gonna select save metadata to file. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And now when I go to Lightroom here, you can see there is the updated image. It might take some time to see the updated file recognized by Lightroom's local browse. The easiest way, if you ever want to force it, is to just quit out of Lightroom and relaunch it. But you now see here, there is the image. And if we go to the edit view, here are all the edits we made to that JPEG. And so again, this should give you peace of mind knowing that regardless of which app you use, whether it's Lightroom or Lightroom Classic, the edits you make should carry over between both apps. And that is great news. Now let's go back to the grid view here and we'll work on a DNG file. And I'm gonna show you the same process. This time again, we're gonna start in Lightroom and we're gonna bring the editing changes to Lightroom Classic. Let's go ahead and click on auto here. Again, we're not really going for much. And what I'll do this time though, is I'll apply a different profile. So I'm gonna apply the Adobe Landscape profile here. Now, remember that we still need to tell Lightroom that we are done with the editing session. If we go to Lightroom Classic over here, this image is still the original. So what we have to do is essentially end the editing session. And again, the way that you do that is by pressing G to go to grid view, or you can press the left or right arrow keys to go to a different image. I'll press G here. That tells Lightroom we're done. Now, when I go over here to Lightroom Classic, I can click on this image here. Or again, if you want, you can right click here. If you don't see any changes, right click, go to synchronize folder, and then make sure that scan for metadata updates is selected and click on synchronize. Now, because this is a DNG file and the edits made to the DNG file are stored within that DNG file wrapper, we don't need to update the metadata like we did with the JPEG. You can see if I double click here and go to the develop module, there is that profile that I changed to as well as all the edits that I made to the image. Now let's flip things up and I'll go to this DNG file here. Let's go to the develop module. And just like before, I'm just gonna click on auto. Again, I just wanna do something that illustrates a change to the image that's really visible. So I'll add some clarity here. And this time I'm gonna desaturate it a lot, but I'm gonna boost the vibrance. So we have this kind of washed out bleach bypass look. Now let's go to grid here. And again, what we need to do is tell Lightroom Classic to write that information to the metadata of this DNG. So in the library module, let's go to metadata. And I'm going to select update DNG preview and metadata because we're working with a DNG file. So I do that, and then I'm gonna move over to Lightroom. You can see that the image was removed and re-added because there was a change made to it. Here it is. Now, if I go and access the edit panel here, you'll see here are all the changes I made, including the vibrance and saturation changes. So working with a DNG file is actually really easy because, again, the metadata, the sidecar file, is embedded with the actual RAW file. Now let's look at RAW files. So in this case here, I have Sony RAW files because I'm a Sony shooter and the RAW extension is ARW. This will be basically the same whether you're using a Canon, a Nikon, or a Fujifilm camera. The point is when you go to the Finder here, for every RAW file, you should have a sidecar file. Now, if you don't have a sidecar file, that just means that you'll have the original image without any metadata changes to it, aside from what the camera wrote. Now, the reason why I have these XMP sidecar files is because I added these 3-star ratings to the image. The star rating is a piece of metadata that sits outside of the actual RAW file, which is why Lightroom wrote this information here. But the important thing is that if you don't have this information, it's not a big deal. It just means that you're going to lose out on the editing changes you made. But let's go ahead here. Let's open this first RAW file. Like before, we'll make some changes to the image in Lightroom and then bring it over to Lightroom Classic. So what I want to do here is show you something like cropping. So if I go to crop here, this is another piece of information that can get transferred over. So I'm going to tighten up here on this lizard and let's again click on auto and that looks good. Now, once again, what we need to do is press on G to basically commit the edit session. And if we go over to Lightroom over here, Lightroom already sees that there is a change to the metadata. Remember with this image here, I showed you what you have to do is click on this icon and then click on import settings from disk. And that will tell Lightroom Classic to overwrite the metadata it has in the catalog with the metadata in the XMP file on the desktop. So here, if we double click on this image and then go to develop, you'll see here, not only do we have the edit state, but we also have the crop state here. So this really is a non-destructive sync as well. You can go ahead and reset this crop or readjust it, but that information is here. And to wrap things up, let's go to our final image here. I'll double click and let's go to develop. And the other thing that I want to show you that carries over is masking. So if I go to the masking panel here and click on sky, Lightroom will automatically detect the sky. And then I'm going to go ahead just to make it really visually clear that we made a change to the sky. I'm going to bring that temperature way over to make it super cool. Then I'll go to the editing panel here. Let's click on auto like we have been doing. And you can see here we have quite a different image. Now again, even though I can go to the grid view, that change will not appear here in this image until I do one thing. And that is by going in the library module to metadata and then selecting save metadata to file, that's going to write the information to that XMP file on the desktop. And when I swipe over, you can now see here is the image. If I double click on it and then go to the masking panel, you'll see there is the mask that we created as well as the edits that we made after the fact. So again, not only does cropping get synced between the two apps, but so do the masks. All right, so that should be pretty comforting, right? Like that should give you peace of mind knowing that on one hand, you can now start getting comfortable and familiarizing yourself with Lightroom, familiarizing yourself with how the editing tools are laid out, and knowing that any edits you make, whether it's just making regular edits or it's making local edits using masks or it's cropping, that information can be copied over to Lightroom Classic. So you don't have to lose any of that, you know, or any of those changes that you make. And if you make edits in Lightroom Classic, you know that you can go into Lightroom and those edits will be made available. Just remember you have to go to metadata and then save that metadata to the file. But again, it's not like you have to make copies of files, make duplicates so that you can work in two different environments. Again, the editing tools between Lightroom and Lightroom Classic are the same, so might as well take advantage of that. And if this video inspired you to the point where you're like, yeah, I'm ready to learn more about Lightroom, please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. Links in the description below. I also have this playlist with other Lightroom videos to help you get started. And as always, if you found this video enjoyable, please click the thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.